Shalom, Matisyahu. Welcome to Israel.
Shalom, Yoni.
So you tour the world, but what does it mean for you to come here, to come to Israel and perform in Israel?
Well, being in Israel is great for me. It's a special place, obviously. It's had a big part in my history in terms of making music, in terms of being Jewish, in terms of my own search for my own Jewish identity, my own searching through Jewish spirituality and religion and all of that. So it's always played a major part in my life, and being here and playing music here, there's absolutely nowhere else in the world that, to me, I would rather be playing music.
Were there any second thoughts because of, you know, the situation?
Nope, no second thoughts at all.
Why?
Just because, you mean over the recent things that have been going on? Because I mean, it's not really my practice to cancel shows for any reason.
So first of all, tell us about the show you put together for the audience here in Israel.
The show's coming up Saturday night at Sultan's Pool. I'm here with the guitar player Aaron Dugan, who I started with many years ago, as well as bass player Stu Brooks from the Dub Trio, who I've been playing with for several years, and three musicians from New Orleans, younger guys who have never been to Israel before and are excited to be here. So we're all thrilled to be here and excited to play our music.
A few words, if you can, about the show in Spain. Tell us about the feeling when you're out there on the stage and in front of you the Palestinian flags, the protest.
Well, so as I was watching the stage from the side of the stage, I was watching the performer before me. I saw a Palestinian flag, and I was aware that there might be something that would go on. And then when the band was changing out, all the flags went up, and as well as the fingers and the whole thing. It was a pretty intense situation. And so I decided to change the first song, because I was going to play a song to start out that was like a little bit more easygoing. And then I decided to play Youth, you know, which is sort of opens with a kind of like a rock guitar kind of heavy thing, as I felt that was the energy that was sort of there. So I didn't want to fight it. I wanted to try to contain it, actually, and use it as a sort of fire for my own creativity that night. And then at some point, the main emotion kind of shifted from being oppositional to sort of accepting, not accepting, you know, what they were doing, but acceptance of the nature of humanity and how it's all sort of under the all within God, you know, everything that's happening here. So pretty much the,
you know. You decided to sing Jerusalem, and that did have some sort of message, I believe, no?
Yeah, singing Jerusalem was that was a special moment, because the song is, you know, if you know the lyrics in the song and what the song represents to so many people, is a connection to Israel and to the struggle that the Jewish people have gone through over the years. So I felt that I was able to sort of connect with that in the situation.
You know, whether you like it or not, you've become an emissary for many supporters of Israel here and around the world.
Yeah.
Is that good? You're cool with that?
I'm very cool with that, yeah. It's an honor and a privilege.
Now, regarding the music, how much is it still very much influenced by Jewish ideas, Jewish spirit? You know, you've always had a few words.
Well, it's never just been a few words. My music stems out of the Jewish search for Jewish spirituality. And, you know, that's not like, a few words here and there. That's not something that changes. That's the essential nature of my music. So anyone that's listening to my music or has ever listened to my music, it wouldn't even be a question in their mind. They actually relate to the words and to the meaning of those songs in a very personal way, but in a way which is representative of some kind of Jewish search as well.
Matisyahu, thank you very much, and good luck.
Thanks.
Jerusalem, fire forget you, remember it and forget what you're supposed to do. Jerusalem, fire forget you, fire not come for me. Jerusalem.